Money very well spent.
Or Peter William Seal.
Mr. Chairman, thank you very much for the opportunity. I'm not a member of the this committee, but I do have an interest because housing is a particular issue that that runs deep in our communities. And so I want to just direct my remarks on three points that emanates from the Vote Building and Housing Report. First point is the Kiwi Saver Home Start Scheme. The second point is the reference to methamphetamine contamination, and the third point is regards to boarding houses. With the KiwiSaver Home Start Scheme, sir, I noted in the report that the appropriation was underspent by $11 million. And the minister, when asked to explain the underspent, said that it was difficult to forecast the uptake of schemes like the KiwiSaver Home Start Scheme. I find that quite challenging, sir, as to why it is difficult to forecast when you can work on what you currently have now and what has happened on the past. Because when I've asked the minister, the relevant ministers, how many Pacific people have taken up this particular scheme, I'm not getting those answers, sir. And as I said, housing is of particular importance to the Pacific community, because even the Minister of Pacific Island Affairs have noted that home ownership for Pacific people has declined and has continued to decline in the last 9 years. Another answer that concerns me in that report is that the anticipated average grant amount in 2017-2018 is $5,122. Sir, in today's prices, how can 5,122 possibly contribute to somebody, a middle-income age couple perhaps, who have saved 10 or 30,000? How can that possibly, that 5,000 possibly contribute to meeting the requirements of the bank of 20% at least in order to secure a mortgage for a house roughly 500,000 in today's prices? So I'm hoping that the minister could help the House understand how that is possible for people on 5,000 on average from the KiwiSaver scheme to buy a house. We look to the area of methamphetamine contamination. So in my electorate, there's been a number of people who have been booted out by Housing New Zealand on the reason that Housing New Zealand have said that particular house that they've lived in has been contaminated. Now, in the report, we note that the health risk of living in a home where meth has been manufactured is greater than living in a home where it has been used. But I want to ask, sir, is the government on top of regulating who it is that are testing whether these houses are indeed contaminated and to the extent of that contamination? Second question I want to ask is whether the ministry, after kicking out people from these houses due to contamination, do they show them a pathway where they can get a house to live in? Because my experience has been, sir, that even elderly people have been kicked out of Housing New Zealand, and there's been no pathway for them in terms of going into a house. It's one of the reasons why Te Puia Marae, sir, in Mangere, not only last year took on people off the streets, and today, a year later, are taking on people off the street because of the lack of pathway when people are evicted by Housing New Zealand. And one of the reasons they've given is because of meth contamination. The third area, sir, is boarding houses. And I note in that report that the minister references five changes the government has made to improve standards for boarding houses. But the committee also acknowledges that those changes, it's difficult to know who's enforcing that and who pays for the cost of enforcement. But despite those changes the government refers to, sir, I want to lay it on the table in this House so that they know I'm raising it. Boarding houses are a ticking time bomb as long as the national housing crisis exists. Boarding houses are a ticking time bomb. One of these days, somebody in this House has got to take responsibility for death, for rape, for abuse, for violence on young children or couples, because those houses were never meant to house families with children, But that's the case we have today as a result of this national housing crisis.
The Honourable Alfred Narrow.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I rise to answer some of the questions, but also to...